Ukraine versus Austria are on same points, that is 3, and they have the same goal difference, and that is 0. So this match today will get so interesting to see that who qualifies in round of 16. Even though the chances of both of them, Ukraine as well as Austria, to qualify for the round of 16 are immense, because even if the match ends in a draw, it'll make them four best third place teams of six groups. So there's a very high chance that these both countries can qualify in round of 16. Both the teams have played two matches against each other. One is won by Austria and the other is won by Ukraine. The last meeting that they had between the two was won by Austria by 3-2. There are so many similarities between these two countries. First is that both have played twice before at Euros. Second thing is that in this Euro 2020, both have won against North Macedonia and both lost against Netherlands. Third thing is both are looking to advance from this group stage at this tournament for the first time. The match between Ukraine and Netherlands, Ukraine was two goals down. They did not let that affect them and leveled that score. It was 2-2, and then later on Netherlands got a goal and they won the match. But that is the spirit that Ukraine has. On the other hand, Austria lost from Netherlands by 2-0. Marko Arnautovic, a very important player for Austria, he did not play against Netherlands because he was suspended because of insulting a North Macedonian opponent after he scored the goal and celebrated. He has 27 international goals for Austria and he would be available in the squad today. Other than that, the whole squad of Austria is fully fit. On the other hand, for Ukraine, they have Yarmolenko, who has so far been the best player for Ukraine, and also they have Yaremchuk. They both have managed to score in both the games that they had with North Macedonia as well as with Netherlands, and they both scored in those matches and they're very likely to score today too. Other than that, Denis Popov has calf injury, so he might not be available today. Also, Alexander Zubkov got injured against Netherlands, so there's still a doubt that if he will be available in the squad today or not. Other than that, Ukraine has two very experienced players and they have a very big role to play today. One is Zinchenko, who plays for Manchester City and has been very significant for them this season. And second player is Ruslan Malinovsky. He plays for Atlanta and has been very significant for them too. He is a set piece specialist and that is so needed in games like these, to get goals from set pieces. I have a feeling that this match is not going to disappoint and is going to be a lot of fun with a lot of goals. Let's see if that happens or not. My prediction for this match is going to be 2-1 in favor of Ukraine. I have a feeling that Ukraine is going to get through this group stage and get into round of 16. That is highly likely to happen because they have shown a lot of spirit. Let's see if that happens or not. It's half time and the scoreline is 1-0. I knew that Austria is not going to just give it to Ukraine, that, you know, just go ahead and win the match. It's not going to happen. That was pretty clear. But it seems like this is just another Ukraine team playing here. It's not the one that we have seen them play in the previous two matches. And it can be because Austria has shown such aggression from the first minute of the match. Be it the discipline of the game, concentration in the game, be it the passing, be it the pressing from the very first minute, that has actually surprised Ukraine, because Austria is giving it their everything to finish in the second position and to qualify easily. And Ukraine has been completely opposite to what Austria has been till now. Such poor passing from Ukraine. They look so uncomfortable on the ball. There is no holding the ball in the midfield. There are no correct passes going on in the match at all, that you cannot even expect that you can build the game and move the ball ahead to the forward. It's not possible because Austria is closing them down on every move, on every ball. They're putting so much pressure on them in this game. Very poor defending from Ukraine. Not accurate passes or crosses. No pressing of the ball. So uncomfortable on the ball. And there is no build up in the game at all. So much space that Austria is getting just to go ahead and attack. David Alaba has been so good. And it can be because Austria has been so good in the match. They're not even giving a breather to Ukraine. It's not even happening that in the game. And you can see that from the stats. They have almost 13 shots. But Ukraine has had only one shot, one on target. They look so lifeless and so passive. I don't know what is going on with Ukraine. But the coach has to make some changes, some significant changes, if they want to win this match. Or else there's a possibility that Austria might take it away from them that easily. It can happen because Austria is that good in this match. I think there were a lot of expectations from the attack of Ukraine. Yarmolenko, Yaremchuk, then Malinovsky, then Zinchenko in the back. It was really expected that they would create something, but it's not happening at all. Something is not linking up with them. But 1-0 does not really define the scoreline that it truly should be, because Austria was that good. They missed such good chances. The scoreline could have easily been 3-0 till now. Seriously, it could have been that, but Austria did not convert those chances. It can hurt them in second half. if Ukraine finds their footing, if Ukraine comes back in the game, to hurt them with even one goal. Even if they get that one goal, it will really hurt Austria. So let's see what happens in second half. It's full time and the scoreline is 1-0. Austria has won the match and now they are on second position at the table. So it means that Netherlands and Austria will compete in round of 16. And for Ukraine, they'll still have to wait if they are one of the four third place best teams. If there's anything surprising in this match, that would be that Austria got just one goal. The motivation behind the match was very clear for both the teams, for Austria as well as for Ukraine, that they have never really gone through the group stage to round of 16. So it was important for both of them. The motivation was there, but that was lacking in the match from Ukraine. Something was not clicking for them and it really feels bad because they know what it means to directly qualify to go in round of 16, but that has not happened for Ukraine. Nothing was working out for them today. They were the clear favorites to win this match today, but the way Austria came up and, you know, took this match with them, it's really appreciable because they did a commendable job in this match. Ukraine lacked creativity, they lacked quality, they lacked energy. Something was so off about them. Even in second half, it is expected that Ukraine will come up with something from their arsenal, you know, to show something to Austria that they have to prove that they can finish in the second position, but it didn't happen for them. But kudos to Ukraine fans who stood with them till the last minute of the match. That felt really good, even though the result did not end up in their favor. But that's okay, this is a football game and it has to end that way. Somebody would win and somebody would lose, or it would end up in a draw. But never mind, that's how the game ended. And also, there was another match, Netherlands versus North Macedonia. Netherlands scored 3 goals and 2 by Gini Wijnaldum. I'm so going to miss him at Liverpool. Anyhow, Netherlands and Austria are through to the next stage. Let's see what happens next. That's it from me today. Bye.